The Vietnam War was the longest war in Australia's history. Australia's involvement in the Vietnam War was driven largely by the rise of communism in Southeast Asia after the Second World War and the fear of its spread which developed in Australia during the 1950s and early 1960s. As part of the containment policy to prevent the complete communist takeover of Southeast Asia, the United States pledged their support to South Vietnam to defend it from invasion by the communist North Vietnamese. After the US entry into the war, Australia followed, obliged to by the ANZUS Agreement, which confirmed Australian support. Between 1962 and 1972, Australia sent almost 60,000 personnel to Vietnam, including troops, naval forces, and air assets, and would contribute large amounts of materials to the war effort. In 1966, Australia increased its force in South Vietnam by establishing a military base and task force in the Phuoc Tuy province, at the hill of Nui Dat, not far from Long Tan, a village and rubber plantation. One APC squadron and five RAR occupied the site in late May to early June, to be joined by the Task Force HQ, artillery, supporting units and six RAR in June and July. By mid-July, the base was fully manned and had set up a partially secure fenced barrier with regular patrols within 5 kilometres of the base. After Viet Cong bombardment on the 17th of August, B and D companies left the base to search for the gun positions. On the 18th at noon, D Company found cart tracks and took over the search. The tracks split, 10 platoon followed them north while 11 platoon followed east. They soon encountered several VC and opened fire before pursuing them. Suddenly they were hit by massive fire from the northeast and the battle started. Lieutenant Gordon Sharp of 11 platoon was killed instantly along with a few other soldiers, leaving Sergeant Bob Buick to take command.
Bob Buick later reported, not very long into the battle, that Gordon had been killed and that Bob had taken over command.
Gordon Sharp got hit in the throat and died instantly. That dropped me in a big bucket of shit because all of a sudden I'm looking after this crew.
Meanwhile at the base, a concert featuring Little Paddy and Cold Joy was finishing. At the same time, word had reached the task force of the battle, occurring a few kilometres away.
During the second show, I could sense that things were different, things were changing. I could see that officers were sort of being whisked away from the area.
10 and 12 platoons also took fire from VC on the hillside, and it had become obvious that D Company was heavily outnumbered. Approximately 2,500 Viet Cong troops were aimed at the company.
Our intention was to completely surround the Australians, to force them into one small group. As we advanced to close the net, we wanted to kill them all. We wanted an all-out fight to strike decisively, for once and for all, for them to die or for us to die.
At 4:45 p.m., there was torrential rain and visibility was halved as the rain caused a mist to rise off the ground. At this time, 3 Troop 1 APC was placed on standby. In a desperate move, Buick called for precision artillery fire near his position in order for him to retreat with survivors from his platoon.
But there was absolutely nothing we could do. We'd exhausted ammunition, we had in fact taken as much casualties as we could. It is time to piss off.
I said I wasn't prepared to fire on his position, but then he told me he probably had 12 men left.
The 11th platoon made a 150 meter dash back, carrying all the known wounded with them, but had to leave behind 15 known or believed to be dead. At 5:10 p.m, Major Harry Smith requested ammo resupply by helicopter drop. They arrived and dropped sufficient ammunition at treetop height, then returned to base to pick up Alpha Company. At this time, B Company requested permission to join the battle and was accepted. D Company regrouped and quickly set up a defensive perimeter to hold off the ever-intensifying force of VC, while the APC sped to them and B Company approached. The APCs fought off the VC force attempting to flank, causing them to flee back east. The VC made their last attempts to break D Company, but were beaten. As the final shots of the battle echoed through the plantation around 7 p.m, B Company arrived, and the APC's headlights could be seen down the rows of trees.
And all of a sudden, amongst the noise of the machine guns and artillery, there appeared the noise of diesel engine. And here were these armoured personnel carriers coming through the gloom, guns firing, and some of my forward soldiers got up, because the enemy, as soon as these tanks arrived, the enemy just turned and left. Now, there was not another shot fired.
The battle was over. The day after, soldiers returned to the battlefield. 11 Platoon found two of their missing 15 still alive, but wounded. Approximately 500 of the 2,500 Vietnamese and 18 of the 112 Australians had died.
I was not prepared to handle bodies late in the day that were fly-blown. You'd grab hold of an arm and you'd pull him into a hole and the arm would come off and his whole body would be full of maggots.
Many awards were presented to the Australian soldiers after the battle for their achievements. However, due to negative reactions from people in Australia, the veterans were not treated well, and it was not until much later that they received a full welcome home and the recognition they deserved. The Battle of Long Tan is a highly significant event in Australia's involvement in the Vietnam War, as it was a decisive victory for heavily outnumbered Australian troops. The battle is comparable to the Kokoda and Gallipoli campaigns for the great efforts made by the soldiers to fight for their country.